And the next topic we want to talk about is our output and our compiler errors and see what the difference is between them and kind of just touch them briefly and then revisit them as we start coding. So to do that again, currently I'm in CS5. I have to create first a new ActionScript 3.0 file, which is an FLA file format. Now that I have a file, we could actually see that I already have preset because I'm in my bin settings, where in my bin settings I've put my output panel and I put my compiler errors up here. If you don't find it, you could always again go to your window, search for your output, you'll reach output, or you could search in your window, go to your compiling errors, and see your compiling errors. What is output? What is compiling errors? And we're going to see this much more into depth, but we just want to get right now a very, very quick overview of what they are. Let's start with the compiling errors. Compiling errors happen basically when you build your applications and you've done a few things wrong in your code that are clear cut for Flash. It knows you made a mistake, which could be that you assigned the wrong value, you've typed something incorrectly, you've missed a parameter, or you've added too many things. Flash then will know that you've made a mistake, or it would notice that you're doing something that you might not mean it, and then it might want to give you a warning. Now, without showing a live example right now, because I'm going to do that as we start touching the programming part of this course, all of the errors that are related to your mistakes into your syntax or your mistakes into things that are clear-cut, Flash knows you made a mistake, they're going to be outputted here as soon as Flash tries to build out your application. As soon as that Flash tries to convert, like we were saying, convert your application into that tier, mid-tier language that then the Flash player knows how to run with. Now, any error that's clear-cut will actually compile and come directly into your compiling errors and then prevent you from, you know, you won't be able to complete your compiling. Now, what does the output do? Output, on the other hand, does not happen while your application is compiled. It happens after your application compiles. So after your application compiles, if Flash finds some error or warning or message that it needs to tell you after the application is running, which it couldn't tell you in advance, such as it couldn't find a file that you tried to load, which is a great example where there's a warning that Flash gives an error and then it says it can't find it. Or things that are, well, probably more detailed than what we get right now, but basically mistakes that we've made that Flash couldn't realize, they didn't notice until it was too late, until after we compiled. So then on the fly, Flash will then generate errors when it notices that they happen. And they would output into our output panel and not into our compiling errors. What else could happen in the output? In the output, and we're going to see that really shortly, we could actually send messages to the output as we're trying to run our application. Now, it's important to note, obviously, our compiling errors and our output are not visible to our end user. Although programmers would be able to see our outputs if we don't omit them, if we don't get rid of them. But our basic users, if they're running it on their phone or they're running it on the browser or an AS3 application, they would not see those messages that are running in our output. Okay, so we know the definition, the difference between compiling errors and the output, and we're actually going to see that in action really soon.